Hello there. Welcome back to Delight Channel, Development, Empowerment and Leadership Initiative. This is an NGO with a vision of world transformation, one man at a time, one community at a time. And this week we are continuing what we started last week, which was our exploration of the concept of retirement. If you missed last week's video, I encourage you to please go back and watch. Very, very brief. It provided the perspective of what we are about to do in the next couple of weeks. And so this week, we are coming down to about 45,000 feet above sea level. And what are we talking about really about retirement? We are saying that, why do people retire? What causes people to retire? Before you move, don't ever forget, if you don't move, you get moved. But let me backstep two steps just to recap what retirement really is. And like I said last week, retirement is the withdrawal from your position or occupation, or you're stopping to continue your active working life. All right? So retirement means that when you say you are retired, you shift from your daily grind of 8 to 5, 9 to 6, 7 to 12, whatever it is your routine that you're running. And it is not something to be afraid of, which is really the starting point for this series. I want to look you straight in the face and say, take the fear out of retirement. Sincerely, take the fear out of retirement. Some people are already panicking now. And it is not really important how old or how young you are. The point is, research and statistics have shown that what makes people die quickly after retirement, or what makes them have a very torrid time during retirement, is not really about money or lack of it, which is actually an important thing, and we'll come down to that, or whether they are able to pick their bills or whether they're able to travel, is usually on the psychological part. Many years ago, about 1997, 96, 97, there was a downturn in the oil sector, and which is not unusual because that sector, like every other sector, goes through cycles. And then Shell, one of the biggest oil producing companies of the world, had to lay off a couple or a lot of its employees in Nigeria at that time. I was running a master's program. And it was shocking to realize that about 12 months after the retirement wave, over 50% of the retirees were dead. Now, that became a topic of interest for one of my lecturers at that time. And as you probably will have guessed, it wasn't because of money, because you know, from the name of the company I mentioned, they would have been given a healthy golden handshake. But still, many of them died months after retirement. Why? That is exactly what I'm speaking to this video. Take the fear out of it. It's on the psychological part. It's on the emotional part. You need to include retirement in your plan. Like I said last week, it's same as death. It doesn't make noise, it doesn't scream, it doesn't shout, because it knows that there is no getting past it. You must include retirement in your thoughts. And it's not something to be afraid of. It's not something to be overwhelmed with. It's actually something to look forward to. You know, they used to say, grow old, retire, and have fun. That is what it should be. Yes, there is no pension in many employment. Yes, the government has even stopped paying gratuity. Yes, many people do not even have any idea of how to deal with it, which is why we are here. But there is a part that nobody can do for you. It is a part of you not getting overwhelmed with the thought of retirement. You need to look forward to it. You need to be excited about it. Why? It affords you time to actually enjoy life on a different level, particularly when you have taken care of the things you need to take care of. And we'll come down to that in a bit. It affords you opportunity of indulging yourself a bit. And when I say indulging, I'm not necessarily talking about negative things. I'm talking about having time now to read more, practice your sport, practice your profession, volunteer more, travel more. Just have a fuller, richer life with your family, with your children, with your grandchildren. These are things that money can't buy. They are the things that make our life richer. So it's a period to be looked forward to. If you can overcome the psychological burden of retirement, then you are making yourself ready to take in the things that we're about to share and the things that you will soon discover on your own as we continue this conversation of retirement. Now, what makes people retire? Sometimes you have to retire upon the attainment of the retirement age. It could be 60, it could be 65, it could be 70, depending on the industry or the profession or who your employer is. Sometimes you also have to retire because you have attained the maximum number of years in service. For some, it's 35 years. For some, it may be 30. For some, it may be 45. So it is whichever comes first, either the attainment of the maximum years of service or attainment of retirement age. But for some, it's a completely different conversation. It could be that your job is no longer required, and so your organization lay you off. And that's another thing we are going to cover on this channel, because some professions are going extinct. I remember growing up as a child, it was a big deal to have a post office box. It was a big deal to have a private mail bag. It was a big deal for organization to deal with their mails. I remember there used to be a man, admin manager, they used to call him, that's responsible for movement of mails when the organization wants to send out letters, or when letters come into the company and then they need to sort and then they need to issue to this, to that, to that. There used to be a big book where you need to sign for collected or issued. Well, did you see that? Gone. In fact, most organizations no longer have that role as a standalone role called admin. I remember also working for the university many years ago that typing was a big deal. They would go to school to study 35 words per minute, 45 words per minute. Some even learned shorthand. Sad to see that some schools in Nigeria are still training on how to use shorthand. But again, another matter for another day. But the point we are making is, where are those professions right now? Except for the public sector, I'm not sure if there are still typewriters in use. Maybe, I don't know, it's been a while I saw any, but certainly not in the private sector. And I know for a fact that very, very few people have typists. Very few organizations now have typists, or even senior people have secretaries that are solely for typing. Most executives now do their own mail, they type their own letters, email has taken over, and therefore that job has largely gone extinct, and many more are coming. Like I said, we'll come back to that. So for that reason, or because the company is shutting down, or some of you also because of entrepreneurship, there is a fire burning in your bone and you are keen to run after it, you are keen to make it come alive, and you stop the grind to go and pick up another grind. And that is why I said last week in our video that the concept of retirement is completely different in this generation compared to that of our parents. But whatever it is, you need to know that the time will come in your life, whether willingly or unwillingly, when you will not be able to move at the speed or at the level of intensity in which you used to move. That is what this video seeks to explore. And therefore, next week, we will now be talking about what exactly are the details, what are the myths, what are the facts, how do you get yourself ready, what are the things you need to do now, how do you keep your eye on the ball, how do you ensure that when the time comes for you to walk through that door, you can do it with a lot of plumb and confidence and excitement, knowing that it's something you've earned and you are determined to enjoy. That's exactly what we'll be covering in subsequent videos. So make sure you make it a day between next week as we continue the conversation. Share it with your friends. Many, everybody needs to hear this. Let them know. And until I see you next week, T-Mac is still my name. And don't ever forget that what we are trying to do is what? Make a little difference. I hope to see you next week. Bye.